our flag is down right where she's staying there.
When it comes to research,
close fire medium.
These two have it down.
Temperature 68 degrees.
To a science.
31 leaves.
So do these two.
This one is 36 inches tall.
Throughout the summer, two groups are working in pairs searching for milkweeds in prairies near Cornell College.
The milkweed is the only plant that the monarchs will lay their eggs on and the only plant that the caterpillars will eat off of.
And so we go through each milkweed, we measure how tall it is, and we write it down, and we check for eggs, how tall it is, how many leaves it has, and so on.
They're also examining the plants to discover if any monarchs might be on them eggs.
They're usually a yellowish, whitish color like this one is, and they have lines on them.
To caterpillars.
There's five different instars, which is five different sizes of the caterpillar before it turns into a chrysalis. And each one gets a little bit bigger, and it's approximately 10 to 14 days where they can until they've turned into a chrysalis.
We're trying to get the numbers of monarchs in the area through their larval stage, egg stage, caterpillar stage, so we can kind of get a grasp on the mortality rates of them throughout the season, and also if they're still declining in population.
The four students are working with Professor Tammy Mildenstein to study the relationship between monarchs and prairies.
We know that prairies have been decimated and are now less than 1% of the original cover that they used to have in North America. And so the assumption is the loss of prairies has led to a loss of milkweed, which has led to a loss of monarchs. So our overall question is, how many milkweeds does a typical prairie produce? We're talking about restoring prairie to restore monarchs, but we don't know how much prairie to restore until we know how many milkweeds a prairie produces, and then how many monarchs will a milkweed plant produce.
The students say the monarchs have a lot of natural predators, which doesn't help with survival rates. They hope their research contributes to the larger question of why the population is declining.
21 leaves, nobody home.
And as they keep counting and collecting data, they know their research is adding up.
For me, it is fieldwork experience, which will look really good when I'm applying to grad school or to jobs in the future. It's also just a really fun thing to do for the summer. I get to work with one of my favorite professors.
It's been great this summer working with these two groups of students. I love the enthusiasm. I learn something from them every week.
This is just one story detailing all of the summer research projects going on at Cornell College. Watch for others on the Cornell College News Center or follow us on Facebook for more information.